Hi, hello, how are you? Welcome to Chapman World.
When I decided I was going to do a video on binary, I thought back to how I learned binary as a child, and how I learned programming in general, in fact. When I was just 5 years old, my parents bought for me a programmable computer, which in 1984 was unusual. That computer was one of these. This is the Tandy TRS-80 Color Computer 2. This became known as the CoCo by its fans later because of it being a color computer. Now the TRS-80 came with a programming manual, and it was this one. Getting started with Color Basic. And it features this kind of cartoon character computer on the side here. Now in the book they don't name this character, but I decided to call him CoCo after the pet name for the computer. I guess you could say that CoCo was my mentor.
Hi, my name is CoCo. Today, I'm going to teach you all about binary. You'll learn how to convert numbers from decimal to binary and back again. And you'll learn how to do addition in binary. In fact, by the time we're done, you won't need cumbersome decimal anymore. You humans count in decimal. Decimal has 10 symbols, called numerals, to represent any number from 0 through to 9. Let's count together. 1, 2, skip a few, 8, 9, oh, we've run out of numerals. To keep on counting, we start back at 0 and place a 1 to its left, 10, 11, and so on. When we have more than one numeral in a number, like this, we call each position a digit. Each digit's position indicates its significance. For example, in the number 23, the first digit represents 2 tens, and the second digit represents 3 ones. The number of numerals in a numbering system is called its base. Because decimal has 10 numerals in its base, and the position of a digit changes its significance, we call decimal a base 10 positional numbering system. The last digit position in a positional numbering system is called the unitary digit. The unitary digit always has a significance of 1 because it represents the number of ones. The significance of each digit to the left is a power of the base. So, for decimal, if we start at the unitary digit and move one digit to the left, we multiply 1 by the base, 10, giving the next digit to the left a significance of 10. Let's do it one more time. Starting in the tens digit, we multiply by the base, 10, and we get 100, making the next digit to the left the hundreds digit. See? Okay, you're doing great. Now let's talk about binary. Binary is a base 2 positional numbering system. That means there are only two numerals, and their position changes their significance. It's just like decimal, but with only the numerals 0 and 1. Just so you know, in binary, we don't use the word digit. This is because the word digit is derived from the Latin word digitus, meaning finger or toe. The decimal numbering system is designed to allow you to count using your fingers or toes. Heh, you humans do amuse me. Most computers don't have fingers, so in binary, we use the word bit instead. The position of each bit has significance, just as in decimal, but because binary is base 2, the significance of each bit is calculated in multiples of 2 instead of 10. Take a look. From right to left, we have 1, 2, 4, 8, 16, and so on. If we have the number 1, 0, 1, the leftmost bit means that there is 1, 4, the middle bit that there are no 2s, and the third bit that there is 1, 1. Also note that we read the number as individual bits, 101, to avoid confusing it with a decimal number 101. In decimal, this is actually the number 5. I bet you've realized this already, but binary numbers are a lot longer than decimal. 101 is a 3-bit number in binary, but only a single digit 5 in decimal. Let's convert a number from decimal into binary together. We'll convert the number 173. In decimal, 173 is a 3-digit number, but in binary, it will be 8 bits wide. So we'll start with our 8 positional bit columns like this. The first bit counts the number of 128s. Well, 128 fits just one time into 173. So we put a 1 in that bit position, and we subtract 128 from 173, leaving a remainder of 45. The next bit position is the number of 64s that will fit into your remaining 45. Well, 64 doesn't fit into 45, so this bit is a 0. On to the next bit. How many 32s fit into 45? Just 1. So we write a 1 and subtract 32 from 45, leaving a remainder of 13. Our next bit position is the number of 16s that fit into our remainder of 13. So again, we have a 0, and we move on. Our next bit position is the number of 8s. Well, there's 1 8 in 13, so we write a 1, and we have a remainder of 5. The next bit position is the number of times 4 fits into the remainder of 5. So that's a 1, and we have a remainder of 1. The next bit position is the number of times 2 fits into our remainder of 1. So that's another 0. And our final bit position is the number of 1s remaining. So we write a 1 and subtract it to leave us with 0. And that's it! We just converted 173 into binary. I did cheat a little bit for you, though. You see, I already know that 173 in binary takes 8 bits, so I made sure we had enough to work with. When you're converting decimal numbers into binary for use in computer programming, you can follow this simple rule. You can't put a numeral other than 0 or 1 into any bit position. So, if the first bit position significance, in our example, 128, fits into your decimal number more than once, you'll need more bits. Generally, computers use arrangements of 8, 16, or 32 bits to store numbers of different sizes. For the mathematicians among you, you can calculate the precise number of bits required to store any number. The formula goes like this. Number of bits equals the ceiling of the log base 2 of the decimal to be converted. Now let's prove that we got our conversion to binary right by converting it back to decimal. Converting from binary to decimal is even easier. All we do to convert from binary to decimal is to add together the bit significance of each bit position that has a 1 in it. In our case, we add 128, 32, 8, 4, and 1. 128 plus 32 is 160, plus 8 is 168, plus 4 is 172, and plus 1 is 173. See how easy that was? Now that you're an expert at converting numbers from decimal to binary, let's look at how we do addition in binary. We'll add the decimal numbers 2, and 9 to get 11. 2 in binary is 0010. 9 in binary is 1001. We do addition in binary in much the same way as we do it in decimal, starting on the right and working back to the left. We add each pair of bits. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 0 plus 0 is 0. And 0 plus 1 is 1. So our result is 1011. Go ahead and convert that back to decimal. Do you get 11 like I did? Great! Let's try another example. This one is just a little bit tricky, but I'm sure you'll get the hang of it. This time, we're going to add 3 to 9. Sounds simple enough, right? Well, 3 in binary is 0011, and we've already seen 9 in binary is 1001. So let's start with the rightmost bits and work backwards again. 1 and 1 is... I'll bet you're tempted to say 2, right? Well, remember that this is binary. We don't have a numeral for 2. In binary, the number 2 is represented as 10. So we have a 2-bit result for the addition of our rightmost bit. What should we do? Well, we do the same as we do in decimal. If we add two single digits, say 5 and 6, to get a 2-digit result of 11, we use a carry to move the most significant digit back to the left. Let's add a carry bit to our diagram. Okay, let's start over in the rightmost bit. 1 plus 1 is carry 1 and 0. Great. Now we just add up the next bit to the left, remembering to include the carry. 1 plus 1 plus 0 is again a carry and a 0. The third bit is 1 plus 0 plus 0, so that's a 1. The final bit is 0 plus 1, that's also a 1. So our result is 1100. Sure enough, that's 12 in decimal. Good job! Wow, we're almost done learning to convert to and from binary, and to do some simple arithmetic. But there's one more thing we should look at, subtraction. If you think about it, when you know how to do addition and subtraction, you could also do multiplication and division. In order to multiply, you just keep adding. And to do division, you keep subtracting until you reach zero. So if we just learn to do subtraction in binary, you'll be able to perform all four of the arithmetic operations. The good news is that you already know how to do subtraction. You just may not have realized it yet. Consider subtracting 6 from 9 in decimal. Normally, you'd write it like this. 9 minus 6. Okay, but there's another way to write it, like this. 9 plus negative 6. Whenever you add a negative number, you get the same result as if you'd subtracted the positive of the same number. This remains true in binary, so you can already do subtraction by performing the addition of a negative number. All that you need to understand then is how to represent a negative number in binary. There are several schemes for representing negative numbers in binary, but they don't all work for our addition and subtraction operations. We're going to walk through three different schemes for representing negative numbers until we get the one that works for addition. The first scheme appears fairly obvious, and it's called signed magnitude. Consider the number 6 in binary, 110. Signed magnitude says that in order to specify if this number is positive or negative, we simply add a bit to the left. This new left bit is not a part of the number, but simply a flag to indicate the sign of the number. When it is set to 0, the number is positive, and when it is set to 1, the number is negative. So positive 6 becomes 0110, and negative 6 becomes 1110. This scheme is very simple, and it has the advantage that it does not actually change the binary representation of positive numbers. Because positive numbers are written without any trailing zeros, a positive sign bit is simply omitted, leaving the original binary number. The problem with this scheme of signed magnitude is that it doesn't work correctly for the arithmetic. Let's add the positive and negative representations of 6 using the addition technique we learned earlier to see the problem. 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 1 is carry 1 and 0. The carried 1 plus 1 plus 1 is carry 1 and 1. The carried 1 plus 0 plus 1 is carry 1 and 0. So we get a result of 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. Taking the first bit as the sign, we have the curious result of negative 0, 1, 0, 0, or in decimal, negative 4. Clearly, this has not worked, but we can do better. The second scheme we're going to look at is called 1's complement. It works in a similar way to sign magnitude, but gets us closer, though not entirely, to the desired result. To create the negative of a number in a 1's complement, we still add a sign bit, just as we did for signed magnitude, but then we flip all of the bits after the signed bit. That is, the zeros become 1's and the 1's become zeros. So the number 6 in 1's complement is still 0110, and negative 6 becomes 1001. Again, we'll perform the addition of negative 6 to positive 6. 0 plus 1 is 1. 1 plus 0 is 1. 1 plus 0 again is 1. And 0 plus 1 is 1. So we end up with 4 1's. The first one is the sign bit, and it's negative, which means that we need to flip all the bits after the sign bit. This gets us back to 1000. If we ignore the sign bit, we can see that we got the correct result of 0. But we still have a problem. The sign bit is still 1. According to 1's complement rules, the answer is negative 0. The number 0 sits between the positive and negative numbers of any numbering system. It has no sign. Using 1's complement, however, there are two possible combinations of bits which represent 0. What's the solution? 2's complement. To get the 2's complement of a number, we take the 1's complement and add 1. It's that simple. So let's subtract 6 from 6 again by adding the 2's complement of negative 6 to positive 6. 6 is represented as 0110. We get the 1's complement negative by setting the first bit to 1 and flipping the remaining bits. 1001. To get the 2's complement, we add 1. 1 plus 1 is carry 1 and 0, so we get 1010. Now let's add the two values. 0 plus 0 is 0. 1 plus 1 is carry 1 and 0. The carried 1 plus 1 plus 0 is carry 1 and 0. The carried 1 plus 0 plus 1 is carry 1 and 0. In this case, we carried 1 into the sign bit and also got a carry out. But because the sign bit is not a part of the number, we can simply drop the carry out. This leaves us with the result of 0000. We now have our correct answer. We are now able to perform subtraction in binary numbers by simply flipping the sign of the term on the right and performing addition instead. You now have the knowledge to convert numbers from binary to decimal and back. You can perform addition and subtraction, and with a little repetition, you can perform multiplication and division too. There's just one thing left. We've only looked at how whole numbers work. What about fractional numbers? Well, that's a whole other discussion. And now that I've got you started in binary, I think I'll let Craig have that discussion with you when you're ready. As for me, well, another of my students is struggling with sorting algorithms. I'm going to hop on over there and help her out. Goodbye, Craig. Good luck with your virtual machine project.
Like, subscribe, and hit the bell.